Today we are going to talk about very nice topic, visualization. How the DBA can visualize the database information, the database statistics to support his daily activities. Okay, this is actually a huge topic. We are going just to touch or introduce this topic. So let us start by one example. Okay, let us start. We have archive logs. We need to examine or review the archive logs generation frequency for our database. How we can get this information? So if you want to query the database about how many archive logs were generated per hour along the day and across the last month, how we can answer this question? Okay, one DBA can say, okay, let us count the number of logs switches in the alert.log file. Fine, this is correct, but is it the simplest way? Another DBA can say, let us write number of queries. Each query answer one part of our question and then merge all the results together. Okay, this is also fine. What if we can answer the above question with a simple map, with a simple graph like the following one? Wow. Okay, so this is a graph generated actually from the database. We named this graph archive log heat map. So here you have the hour per day, 0 until 24 hours, and here is the day, maybe 2 weeks, 1 month, or whatever. And here for each hour across the day, and across the months, you can easily see the number of generated archive logs with different colors, with different based on the number of archive logs. Okay, so even the color itself it changes based on the number of archive logs. So here from one graph you can get all the information about the generated archive logs per hour, and this reflects the database maybe write activity or commit activity. Okay, credit to this type of graph goes to David Mann. This graph actually is generated or is developed as a report inside SQL Developer, Oracle SQL Developer. The same info, but instead of the number of archive logs generated, we need to know the daily redo gigabyte, how gigabyte generated per hours, how the gigabyte generated per hours. So the same, we have hours across the day, we have days across the months, and here how many gigabytes per hour generated with different colors. Okay, and here is the total total gigabit generated per day, per day. So it's a very nice graphs, and this simplifies actually the daily activities of our DBAs. What else? What about database workload profile? I want to see the database workload profile along the day and across 1 month, for example. How can I see this workload profile? This is another example. Here is a database, a RAG database, and this is the workload profile for instance 1 and instance 2. What is here inside this graph? This is the date and this is the value. We are graphing here two matrix, database time, database CPU time. I am assuming you are already aware of this matrix. So from here you can see how the load is changing across the day and across the months, and you can see the peak time, across, for example, 1 month, and you can pinpoint the time, the exact time where you have a bottleneck, performance bottleneck, and then you can drill down, for example, generating AWR reports across the peak time and examine the problem. So actually this type of graphs is very powerful for troubleshooting performance issues. You can also see the distribution of workload across the rack, across instance 1 and instance 2, which instance is highly loaded, for example, and you can distribute the work after that evenly. So this is another example to visualize the performance statistics. This is another example also to visualize many metrics. Performance metric, for example, host CPU utilization, average active session across one day or one week or whatever, logins per second, read size per second, logical reads per second, and many other metrics, execution per second, commits, rollbacks per second, hard parses, user calls, and many metrics that you can visualize. This is performance statistics matrix. Actually, these graphs are developed by using a Python program. I developed this matrix by reading or querying the database statistics and then visualize it. So using this type of graphs actually simplify our life, and it's very nice and it's very powerful. Okay, this is just introduction. Thank you for watching. For example, if you want this type of queries, if you want the SQL statements or query behind this report, please subscribe to my channel, like and comment this video, and send me your email in the comment, and I'll send you an email with the queries directed to you. Okay, thanks again, and see you in my coming videos, inshallah. Thanks, bye.